Hello from Chem Help ASAP. Let's cover the idea of drug formulation, which is critical for delivering an efficacious drug dose to the patient. Upon completion of this video, students will be able to contrast a drug substance and a drug product, demonstrate the effect of acid-based salts on drug properties, and list considerations for preclinical and clinical formulations. Drug formulation is a large research field that designs the final medication that will be administered to patients. In drug discovery, most design efforts focus on a biologically active compound that causes the therapeutic effect, the drug substance, also called the active pharmaceutical ingredient, or API. The final medication is called the drug product and includes both the drug substance and excipients. Excipients are materials that may improve properties such as drug dissolution or absorption in the body, or improve the storage stability of the medication. Materials like bulking agents in a pill are also excipients. Formulation research for a specific drug varies widely based on the route of administration. Developing a formulation for an injectable drug is very different from formulation research for an oral drug. Pre-formulation activities focus on the properties of compounds in the lead series, especially solubility and stability. A large fraction of active drugs contain functional groups with acidic or basic properties, and the final drug will often be prepared as an acid-base salt. The identity of the counterion in the salt can have a large impact on drug solubility, and salt selection is often a critical step. For example, imipramine, an antidepressant, has a basic amine. The hydrochloride salt dissolves quickly and provides rapid release and absorption of imipramine in the GI tract. The pamoate salt dissolves more slowly and provides an extended, sustained release of imipramine to a patient. Tuning solubility and delivery through salt selection is a common task of pre-formulation. Once animal studies are initiated, the lead compound will need to be formulated for administration to animals. Early studies will likely require an IV and oral formulation. For IV administration, the compound must be completely dissolved, which can pose issues for very poorly soluble compounds. For oral administration, a solid form of the compound can often be suspended in a fluid and administered by oral gavage, essentially a feeding tube. Administration of oral drugs in this manner reduces uncertainty on whether the full dose has been delivered to the animal subject. Minimizing dosing uncertainty in efficacy studies is important, but reducing uncertainty in dosing and exposure is arguably even more important during preclinical safety studies, which determine dosage ceilings for human studies. Underestimating the administered dose could lead to underestimating safety risks. Formulation of a drug used in clinical trials must follow CMC, or chemical manufacturing and control practices, which ensure product safety and consistency between different batches. Beyond delivering the required dose to the patient, formulations will be studied for appropriate temperature and length of storage. Oral medication, whether tablets or capsules, will also be designed for patient comfort, as some patient populations have difficulty swallowing pills. This difficulty can apply to some geriatric patients and pediatric patients, for whom an oral suspension may be preferable. Formulations that are amenable to a patient's needs improve patient compliance and health outcomes. We have now introduced the idea of formulation, which is a vital aspect of drug discovery, as a drug needs to be administered to preclinical species or humans. Without a consistent, reliable formulation, the safety and efficacy of a drug cannot be ensured. That was a very quick summary of the role of formulation in drug discovery. If you have any unanswered questions, always feel welcome to ask them in the comments section. Take care.